On one of our previous episodes, we talked about a moth species called the household case bearer, which builds a mobile protective case and carries it during its larval stage. Case bearers are mostly seen inside or around their homes, but outside their houses, another moth species with the same behavior are also found. Meet the cousins of the household case bearer, the bagworms. Bagworms, or bag moths, belong to the Cycidae family with more than 1,000 described species under the Lepidopteran order of butterflies and moths. They come in different shapes, sizes, and compositions. They are found worldwide where there are plants and vegetation. And in this part of Cagayan de Oro City, there's a community of bagworms that are thriving and may go unnoticed to the people living around the neighborhood. In this area, by taking a closer look around, you can see cases attached to this wall of concrete or to this metal gate. Some are empty already, but occasionally, if you're lucky, you can spot a live one, gingerly crawling, carrying his nifty home. This caterpillar's protective case differs from the case bearers. They may have the same components, such as silk and a little bit of sand and soil, but the bagworm's case are mostly dried plant materials. The bag also gives protection from predators, such as birds and other large insects, as they blend well with their surroundings, mistaking them for a cluster of small twigs or plant debris. The larvae of some species eat lichen, a moss-like organism, while others prefer green leaves, making them occasional nuisance. A few species can also become more serious pests. However, most bagworms are harmless to humans and inconspicuous. One bagworm species in Madagascar are encouraged to breed because its pupae are collected as a protein-rich food. Adult males will transform into moths to seek out females for mating, leaving their bags or house cocoon never to return. However, the females have a different and kind of sad transformation. As the female larva morphs into the adult stage, she would not develop eyes, legs, mouth, wings, and antennae, and would never leave the cocoon. She just emits a strong pheromone and waits for a male to catch the love scent. The male then mates with her through an open end at the back of the case, then die. Most female bagworms also die right away after laying eggs inside their case. The tiny larva bagworm begins to build its case as soon as it hatches. There you go. Weird, but interesting animals that build their own moving houses, where they spend most of their lives. Nothing could be more satisfying than being in the comforts of your own abode. Home, sweet home. Now, you may want to go outside your house and check if you have them, as your neighbors. Good luck! Thank you for watching. See you in the next story! Meow.